Hello there. My name is Alicia, aka Edmiston Creations, and I am a wife, mom, social worker, and athlete living in the mountains of South Central New Mexico. And this is a space where I like to share all about the things that I've been making, the things that I've been doing with my family, working out, and also I like to share some general mental health and wellness tips peppered in with my content from time to time. So if any of that sounds interesting, then this is a space for you and welcome. So it's been a while since I've recorded last, and I've had every intention of getting back on here from week to week, but there's just been different things that have come up. And in March, I had my son's birthday and my birthday, and we had some general things that were going on with the house. We had a stomach bug come through the house. So there was just a lot of barriers, we'll call them, to me really having the time to carve out to record a podcast episode. But I'm back. Here we are. I am going to share some different things that I've been up to since I last recorded. I'm not going to share everything because that would probably be just a really long episode and maybe a bit of sensory overload. So I'm going to spare you that. But I will say, if you follow me on Instagram, my handle is Edmiston Creations on Instagram. If you follow me on there and then you've seen any projects in particular that I've shared on Instagram that you would like for me to share more about and spend more time on here on the podcast, then please comment on this episode or feel free to contact me directly any of the ways that are in the show notes. You can even DM me on Instagram and just ask if there's something you would like me to share more in depth about, or if you have questions about, and I'd be happy to answer those questions and share more about those specific projects if I'm not including them today. Because like I said, I don't want to have an hour and a half long podcast episode since it's been a while since I recorded. So first things first, I am wearing my workout clothes because I just finished a workout, and I worked out in my Harlow hat. This is a brioche goodie by Andrea Mowry, a two-color brioche. I used, this is the worsted Harlow. I used Family Jewels and Wololo. And I love the colors, and I wear this hat a lot to work out in, mainly because it fits my head well, it's warm, and it's just really comfortable. I don't even necessarily, like, it's snug fitting, but like, I don't even really feel it on my head while I'm working out, which is nice. And it keeps all the heat in so I can stay warm. And even though it is spring, we've been having some snowy days here in the mountains of New Mexico. So like the last 2 days, it has snowed off and on all day. And the week before, it was like that for 3 days in a row. So like, we woke up yesterday to a couple of inches of snow outside. It's a dry climate here, so our snow comes and goes quite quick. Like, there's no snow on the ground today. There's a few remnants here and there, but just cold, snowy days. It's still cold, so I'm still bundling up and wearing my wool base layer. I shared about this in the last episode, but this is a smart wool base layer that I work out in all the time. And yeah, it's cold, and I'm ready for it to warm up. And I'm not ready for summer, like 80 plus degrees quite yet, but you know, some 50 degree, 60 degree temps would be nice. I'll take that. So we'll see if that's gonna happen or if that's in the cards anytime soon. But this is the third day of April. And so with that, for those of you that are here for some of the workout content, comes Project April with street parking. For those of you that don't know, I am a member of the street parking online fitness community. It is, you know, just look up street parking, either Google it. They have a great website that can give you more information, or you can check them out on Instagram at street parking. It's a functional fitness program that is tailored to meet your needs, your fitness level, and to make fitness easy and accessible for everyone. As a social worker, I love that, but also as an athlete and a mom, I love that because I don't have a lot of time to devote to working out anymore. And I mean, there's days where I may want to spend a couple of hours lifting or running, but I don't want to do that every single day. And so street parking is a really great program where basically if I have about 30 minutes from start to finish, like warm up, cool down, and all that jazz, like I can get in a really quick, effective workout with minimal equipment or even no equipment if I'm so inclined, and or maximal equipment. You know, like I do have a rower and a treadmill and barbell and squat rack and all those things. So, you know, the days that I want to take it to the max, I can. The days that I want to keep it really minimal and quick, I can do that too. And it's all for a very affordable monthly membership price. Disclaimer, I am not sponsored. I am a paying member of street parking and I just believe in the program and it's awesome. It works for me. But Project April is a fun little challenge that street parking does every April with dumbbells. So like their whole thing is, again, like showing people that you don't need a ton of equipment to get fit or strong. All you need is a pair of dumbbells. And so Project April has started, so I just logged my third dumbbell workout, and I'm feeling good, so I'm really excited about that. And so, like, they have an app where you can log all your workouts, and you get badges, and so I'm working on my Project April badge now, and I'm super excited about it. So, that's what I have been up to, at least this morning. And so let's dive in. Like I said, I have a lot of show and tell, and it's been a while. So let's see what all we've got going on here. I want to start with the finished object that I have, and it is the Melt Shawl by Andrea Mowry. I was so fortunate to be able to test knit this beautiful shawl. I used Bear Paw DK by the Farmer's Daughter Fibers. My main color is Ranch Romance, and then the purplish color I used is Fugitive, and then this nice orangey color is Fight Club. I just love the name, and I did love the combo of these colors together, but this shawl was an absolute joy to knit. I used the recommended needle size, was able to achieve gauge with that. All of my details for this project are in Ravelry, so in the show notes you can get on my Ravelry project page and check that out, but for like specifics about yardage and all of that. I did do the size 1. Now, whenever I tested this, there was 1 size, but when she released the pattern, there's 2 sizes. So this is a size 1, and it's quite ginormous. I mean, you know, I've got plenty of wingspan here to wrap this around and wear. And I will say that Bear Paw DK was an excellent fit for this pattern because of the yak in this yarn base. It drapes. I mean, you can see it just drapes and hangs so nice. And Candace has some of the most beautiful dye colors that to pick from. So 10 out of 10, highly recommend Bear Paw DK for this pattern. But, you know, I mean, there's lots of beautiful DK yarns out there that you could use. So this would also be a great stash diving project if you have a lot of DK in stash that you would like to use. But I really love this shawl. And this is one of the first shawls I've knit in a while. Like, the only other shawl that I have knit was the Betwixt shawl by Amba O'Brien. And I knit that like a year and a half ago. So this kind of turned me into a shawl. I had been wanting to make more shawls. My sister-in-law, Brooke, her handle on Instagram is Knit A Lot of Mama. She knits some of the most beautiful shawls, and I have always wanted to knit more shawls and be like her. But I mean, sweaters have my heart, okay? So it's been hard for me to pull away from sweaters, but this was a perfect opportunity for me to get on the shawl train, and I'm so glad I did. Now I love shawls. And I love wearing them. They're very versatile and functional. So Melt Shawl by Andrea Mowry. I love this. I believe, you know, I mean, she's talked about this a lot already on her YouTube and on her Instagram. But I mean, you know, there's brioche, two color brioche sections, garter stripe sections, and lace sections. It's very straightforward. The pattern is very easy to follow. So yeah, yay, the Melt Shawl. I love you. Okay, so moving on. The month of March brought birthdays. And the first birthday of the month was my son's birthday on March 8th. He was born on International Women's Day, and that just has a very special place in my heart. I mean, it felt sacred giving birth on International Women's Day. I mean, that's a very womanly thing to do on International Women's Day. And just to have that connection with my son, you know, a male energy on International Women's Day. He's quite a gentle soul. And I just, you know, I love that. So for his birthday, I casted on, and it's a little tangled up in my project bag here. But I casted on the anchor sweater, My Size by Petite Knit. So I'm on the yoke still. I haven't picked this up in a few weeks just because I've been working on other things. I am knitting this with a good friend of mine. And this was a stash dive for me. I'm using a merino cotton blend by Expression Fiber Arts. It's her North DK. This was a limited edition, limited offer yarn, but gosh, it's perfect. This is the colorway Kodiak. So it's a nice, like beigey brown. But this is a perfect colorway. And for this sweater, it's a lovely neutral. I'm going to get a ton of wear out of this when I'm done. And it has this lovely connection to my son's third birthday. And I love that. So that's one thing that I've been working on. And then my birthday came March 26th after stomach bug and some other fun things that, you know, we had going on. And I, you know, because I turned into a shawl knitter, I casted on the Cimarron shawl by Brianna Arlen. And this is the first section of the shawl. I am using Bear Paw Sock and Farmer's Daughter Fibers Surrey. This is York, and I don't remember what the other one is. The Sapphire Empress. So I'm using these together in the first section, and then this is also Bear Paw Sock, and this is Surrey and Porch Pumpkin. I don't remember the name of this one, so I'll have to look that up, and I'll put that in the show notes. But But anyway, this is a new shawl design that just came out by Brianna Arlen. She is an up-and-coming knitwear designer from Colorado, and she rock climbs and stuff, and she's a very grounded person. And I had the pleasure of meeting her at the Santa Fe Maker Circle last month, and I really, really like her patterns. They're very well written and they're beautiful. More importantly, they're beautiful, but they're also fun to make. I'm very much a process knitter. And so if I don't enjoy knitting it, it's really hard for me to push through the process, like to get to the end. So this one has really kept me going. I love it. And yeah, so this was birthday cast on number one. This is a shawl for Chelsea, who is Chelsea Knits Sews Throws on Instagram. She is hosting a shawl crawl 2024 where you knit one shawl per quarter. The first shawl that I did with that knit along was the Inclinations shawl, and I will share that another time. I don't have it, you know, right next to me to be able to share today, but this is going to be my shawl for quarter number two. And so I'm really excited to be I knitting another shawl, but also I love that that she's hosting this shawl crawl knit along in such a way that it's, you know, one shawl per quarter. I mean, it makes it very accessible, like, I don't know, user-friendly, accessible comes to mind. But also there's a deadline. So you do have this sense of, okay, I do need to finish this project so it won't go into like the languishing pile. And for me, if something goes languishing, I end up frogging it. I don't let languishing projects sit around for years and years. So, you know, like it helps you to, you know, you have like this nice amount of relaxed time to knit. You really enjoy the knit and the process. It doesn't feel stressful at all, but you have a beautiful shawl at the end of the quarter. So yeah, it's just really been a fun knit along. So if you are interested in joining along, I will put information for that in the show notes as well. But I mean, it's pretty easy. You just pick out and knit whatever shawl pattern you want, and you can use the hashtag #shawlcrawl2024 and on Instagram and show, you know, share your projects. So there we go. This was one of my birthday cast-ons. So this year, I mean, I don't know, I'm not typically like a huge birthday person, but it just felt appropriate to have a birthday week this year for myself. And it wasn't that I did anything like really crazy or out of the ordinary. I would say the one thing that I did that was crazy was the Hesper cardigan came out by Savory Knitting. Literally, she released it the day after my birthday. My birthday is March 26th, and she released this cardigan on Wednesday the 27th. And I immediately was like, oh my God, barn quilts. I love barn quilts. All the years of cycling and running through the mountainside and countryside of North Carolina and seeing barn quilts everywhere, I was like, I have to make this. And, you know, I had picked a shawl to cast on. I'm also going to make a La Bandana by Amy of La Bien-Ami. I don't have that to show you right now. Again, with the whole sensory overload thing, that is happening in the background, though. So I had, like, basically picked two shawls for my birthday cast-ons. So my so my sister-in-law, Brooke, was like, what? Who are you? Like, why aren't you casting on a sweater? And I was like, yeah, I don't know. I'm like having an existential crisis with these shawls. Just joking, you know? And then the next day, the Hesper cardigan came out and I immediately went to my stash and started pulling, and I was determined to make something work, and I casted on the Hesper cardigan. So once I got some progress done, I sent a picture to Brooke and was like, see, existential crisis averted. here's my birthday sweater. So, without further ado, this is the Hesper cardigan by Savory Knitting. I love, love, love this motif. It is so adorable. This is mosaic knitting and intarsia. So you have six colors and you switch across the row. Here's the backside, so you can see as you change colors. I've done intarsia with crochet once, probably 5 years ago, 6 years ago now. So this is the first time I've done intarsia with knitting and the second time I've done intarsia ever. So if I can do it, you can do it. I mean, she has good suggestions in the pattern. I will say my tips with intarsia, again, not that I'm an expert, but what I have learned with intarsia is you have to embrace a little bit of chaos. Your yarn will get tangled or look tangled at times, but you can when it starts to get a little too tangled or a little too unmanageable, just take a pause and untangle it and then just keep going. So that's kind of the yarn management. With the yoke, I'm doing the size 2, potentially the size 1. You can kind of pick your size like after the yoke is, or at a later point in the yoke. So I'm intending to do the size 2, but I'm going to see how things fit as I go here, if I want a closer fitting cardigan or more ease. But so for my size, either a 1 or a 2, there's 54 rows of this, the color work and the motif. So only half of those rows are using the intarsia, you know, 6 colors of the CCs. So think about that. Like, it makes it really, really manageable. I knit this motif in 2 days, mainly because I was obsessed and I couldn't put it down. But so you knit the yoke. Now I'm in stockinette city. So it's going to be straightforward, you know, top down construction. I'll split for sleeves, knit the body. I believe you knit the button band. Yeah, you knit the button band and then you do the collar last and the sleeves. So yeah, I love it. I don't know if you can see, but this makes me think, when I look at this, I see barn quilts, and that makes me so happy. So the colors that I'm using, I am using Metamorphic from Stash that by Spin Cycle as my main color. And then all of my CCs are just random Spin Cycle. I just pulled things. So I do kind of know names of the different colorways and stuff, so I will have those specifics as I get farther along in this project, and I'll probably do a Ravelry project page for this cardigan. I usually only do them for test knits, but this is kind of a special knit, so I'll probably do a project page for it in Ravelry to have the details, so, you know, people can check that out if they're interested in making one. So I will say, so I picked 6, you know, different colors of Spin Cycle, either Nocturne or Dyed in the Wool, and then my main color is Spin Cycle Metamorphic. And I used a basket to hold. I had 3 CCs and the, you know, on the bottom and 3 CCs on the top. If you're doing intarsia, something like this, like, really is helpful. Again, I'm not an expert. This is only the second time I've done intarsia, but I used a basket like this when I did crochet intarsia, and it like saved my life a few times, you know. So it was, well, saved my sanity, I should say, a few times. So something like this is really helpful doing intarsia. And then, you know, now that I'm done with the motif, like, I don't need this anymore. So those are my tips. if you're interested in making the Hesper cardigan. And I really do highly recommend. It's a very enjoyable knit. She also has it written where, I mean, you can just do two colors. You do not have to do intarsia if you don't want to. So there's that. So that's my official birthday cardigan. I'm also on a cardigan kick this spring. I'm going to go ahead and share a little bit about test knits. I am testing for Jeanette Knits again. I am so thrilled to be testing for her again. She is the very first designer that I ever tested for, and Jeanette is just a lovely individual. And she is coming out with the Ostinato cardigan, and I hope I said that right. So my obsession with Ranch Romance really started with the Melt Shawl, but I am making the Ostinato cardigan in Ranch Romance in Candace's new Confluence cotton base, Farmer's Daughter Fibers. And this is an awesome blend of yarn. It is Rambouillet, Targi, and cotton all blended together. And it's got more wool content than cotton. I am not a 100% cotton yarn person. I mean, like, I'm using a merino cotton blend for my anchors sweater, my size, but it's mostly merino. Like, it's mostly wool and a smaller percentage cotton. And that's how this is. And Targi and Rambouillet are two of my favorite wools, like, of all time. So to have those two wools together and then a little bit of cotton thrown in, I love this blend of yarn. So I'm using this to make the Ostinato cardigan. It is a very simple yet elegant looking cardigan with set in sleeves, seamlessly done with short rows. Jeanette is a very talented designer. She has beautiful color work patterns, but she also has a really great eye for textured, like, cabled knits and very simple looking design, like classic designs, I guess, more. And so this isn't denoted as an intermediate pattern. I have not casted it on yet. I will be casting on towards the end of the week this week. I'm very anxious to get started. I cannot wait to knit with this yarn and also have this really cute springtime cardigan. But I will share more of that test knit as I get going. But yeah, no, if I highly recommend Jeanette's patterns, they fit well. All of the things that I have made by her have turned out excellent. So, that's it with, that. And I do have a couple of test knits going on for Andrea, but I will share those whenever the release date comes. And a release date is coming next week, so I can't wait to share more about that sweater. And let's see. Okay, I think that's it with, like, the knitting portion. So with spring and summer coming, I have, like, the sewing bug has hit, like, majorly for me. I have been sewing up a storm kind of in the background here. I've got all these sewing plans. So I am going to be probably sewing more this spring and summer, and then, like, you know, kind of knitting as I go. at least that's kind of what it feels like. So we'll just see what unfolds. But I have sewn a couple of pairs of chanterelle pants. So here is my fun yellow pair. This is out of Linen Knoll from U Fibers. And that's View B of the chanterelles. And this is also View B. I'm obsessed with View B. So this is Merchant and Mills linen. I got this linen from Spin Cycle Yarns a while back, and I really love both of those pants so much. And then two dresses. I sewed both of these dresses as a sew along with Chelsea Knit Sews Throws. And this one is out of Merchant and Mills iCat Cotton from Osser, Santa Fe. We shopped together and bought our fabric together after Maker's Circle last month, and we both made hinterlands. So I did the sleeveless view, and I did Arthur pants pockets on my dress. And I did the shorter skirt version, but I did add 4 inches to my skirt because I do like the skirt to hit like kind of around my knee or just below, or like right at my knee. So I don't have to worry. Like when I just feel like I can move freely with that length skirt. So, and my buttons are from Idlewild Clay, of course. You guys know, if you've been following me, you know I'm obsessed with Idlewild Clay buttons. And then this is the other sew along that I did with her. This is the Horizon Day Dress, and this is all Merchant and Mills linen from Black Mountain Yarn Shop. This is by Matchy Matchy Sewing Club. And I used a little Sarah Hart's label tag in mine. Oh, and I also used a Sarah Hart's label tag in the Hinterland dress too. It says made in New Mexico. Kind of hard to read, but yeah, this is such a fun, like, little patchwork dress. Here's the back. And so the pattern comes with the patchwork option for the skirt, or it just gives you a full, you know, like a solid skirt. So you can do that too. I ended up needing I don't know if you can see, I flat felled my bodice together in the back. I cut out the back bodice and added a 5/8 seam allowance so I could flat fell it together, you know, nicely for a seamless look, because I didn't have enough fabric to cut it on the fold. So this is always a nice option when you don't have enough fabric. Like when you don't have enough fabric to cut something on the fold, you can cut two and just add 5/8 seam allowance and flat fell, and it gives a very nice professional looking finish. So yeah, I'm very excited to wear this dress like a ton this spring and summer. And it was super fun to sew these dresses with Chelsea, so we can be hashtag twinning. But yeah, I am already like, you know, the fun thing about this pattern is you can piece it together so many different ways to use up scraps. So I am going to make another one, but I am going to wait until I kind of accrue a few more linen scraps and stuff. And right now I am sewing a second pair, getting ready to sew a second pair of Arthur pants out of Grace Hemp fabric from U Fibers. I've already sewed one pair and I'm super proud of myself. I'm going to share more about these Arthur pants in my next episode. I took the Fit and Sew Pants class by Sew Liberated that just came out. Highly recommend if you've been intimidated to sew pants and make adjustments. This course totally unlocks all of the mystery for you. And I took what I learned from that course and applied it to the Arthur pants, and I raised the crotch up 3 inches and I redrew the crotch for the back part of the pants to get the fit that I wanted. And I am so proud of myself that it worked out, and the pattern, like, I love the way they fit, and now my pattern is set and I can sew 50 million Arthur pants that fit the way I want now. So hooray. I don't know that I'll sew 50 million, but you know, maybe 10 or 20. I don't know. We'll see where the years take me and how many I sew, but I'm very excited to get to this pair of pants next. And then I have a few different dresses and some more sweatpants and stuff on the agenda, because I am in my cozy era with me made sweatpants, and it is still cold and chilly here. And so sweatpants are still very much a thing and worn. So that's all I've been up to, or not all, but that's a lot of what I've been up to making over the past month. I am very excited. Andrea is hosting a couple of 100-day challenges right now, and she's doing a 100-day knitting challenge. And for 15 minutes a day, it's like a self-care sort of thing. 15 minutes a day, you knit. And I already knit every day, like, so that's really not a lot of a challenge. So I kind of added a twist to this challenge where I am going to at least walk and knit for 15 minutes a day from April 1st. It started April 1st and goes to July 9th for 100 days. But if you join in a little bit late, I mean, it's never too late. You can still join in and then you just add on, like, you know, however many days you need to at the end, like go to July 11th or 15th or whatever, whenever you start. But I'm really excited about this because I really enjoy walking and knitting, but I don't do it as frequently as I would like to. And with the weather in a warming trend now, it makes it more doable, because my hands would freeze in the winter time. I mean, I could knit for like 10 minutes or 5 minutes before my hands would get too cold to knit anymore on my walks. I'd have to put them in my pockets. So, yeah, I am going to do 100 days of at least 15 minutes of knitting and walking. It may be more. I will walk either by myself or with my family or friends, just depending on what I feel like I need that day or what opportunity is there that day. And if the weather is bad, because like day one came April 1st and it was snowing that day. So I did my 15 minute walk in the snow after my workout and then I knit inside. And that for me is going to count because I'm still getting the challenge in. I'm still getting out and walking 15 minutes and I'm knitting. Now if I have if there's a torrential downpour or something like that, then I may not walk that day. I may just knit inside. But for the most part, my plan is, even if the weather is pretty bad, I'm going to bundle up or put on my raincoat or whatever, because it's just 15 minutes. I'm just going to do it. And yeah, I'm really interested to see what I notice and what unfolds as I do this 100-day challenge. So Andrea's hosting this on Ravelry in her groups if you want to see more details. She also has information on Instagram. So, and I'll be sharing some from time to time on Instagram and on here about like how the challenge is going. So if you're interested, please comment, you know, share with me, you know, if you enjoy challenges or not, or if you find them overwhelming, like I would love to hear. And lastly, I'd love to know what you're up to. So please comment on my video, like, subscribe to my channel if you enjoy this content so you don't miss out on anything. And I believe that's it for me for today. Like I said earlier, please get in touch with me if you would like me to answer more specific questions about projects I have shared today or projects I've shared on Instagram and I did not mention today. But for now, I wish you a peaceful rest of your week and happy mindful making.